Looks like the Afghan Taliban's back, bitch. Not, maybe not the Afghan one. Yeah, that'll happen next time. Yeah, the other time we have to invade the middle. It's gonna, we'll get to it, bud. Yeah, jihads and crusades, we're still figuring out how to end them. That's the thing, right? We didn't plan far enough ahead. No, I do, bro. We didn't plan far enough ahead with either of this shit. Right? Kicked a fucking, you might get it. It's like we're bitching at you for this war, and it's like, no, brah. It's like this cycle has lasted thousands of years, Shepard. Straight up, since before you had underwear, Shepard. We've been trying to figure this out, and now that you guys have, our kids are all grown up now, straight up. Now you guys can help us figure this shit out, because all the shit we've been bitching at you for, I already did it a million times. Bro, I told you, it's gonna be a long time before you have enough swastikas and Russian rapist tattoos to be thrown in the fucking maximum security redcoat wing down here. Yeah, I finally got a cellmate, we'll figure it out, bud. I guess that's another one of those, like, insider cultural jokes, like, if you happen to know we're, like, slight, 16th, Cracker John, African, whatever, you know what I mean? Well, you guys are partnering, and then with these guys, yeah, the British are, like, the only ones who know the, oh my God, right? No, I'm sure other people are aware. Yeah, no, sorry, I know you got a bunch of crazy notes there in the fucking corncob pipe fucking laboratory down in the Luftwaffe labs. I know you guys know this shit. I'm just saying, yeah, sorry. Fucking, I'm sure there's some crazy professors. I'm all, yeah, I'm, sh as far as the average public, they might think it's funny. Yeah, in the end, the most Latin douchebag is fucking Sherlock Holmes. Yeah, straight up. You get it. Whatever. It's runner up in the end, it seems like, for the most part, just. English or whatever in German were both the best descriptions of Latin. Even, I know, what about Spanish? Latino? Right. There are differences. I'm just saying that, like, how you guys are so similar, Germans and British. I mean, yeah, I'm part German and part British and part fucking Austro-Hungarian. Yeah. Heinz 57, motherfucker. Afghan Taliban's right over there, and we gotta go talk to the Jews in Jerusalem. Yeah. It's complicated. Yeah, it's complicated when there's more than, like, two colors. Anyway, no, yeah, as the lawyer that's trying to sue you right now, this is probably one of the very few things that Britain's waiting to use against us. Yeah, they got a few rounds left in those cannons, a few pieces of ammo left they can use against us. Yeah, make all those shots count. You only got a few torpedoes, bud. Yeah, straight up. Well, yeah, the Roman Empire is gonna preach to us about war and slavery. Yeah, you know why, dog? Who else knows more about this shit? You get, I'm not personally, just I culturally, whatever. You probably get it. Yeah, a lot of stuff might have been censored, but with such a large sample size, even if only 5% of our history remained, it's still 10 times bigger than. Yeah, you get it. Yeah, your ancient mystical tattoos from 200 years ago. Yeah, straight up. Maybe 500 or 600. Yeah, I'm stretching the taffy a little. You guys were, I'm just saying, remember, before or after you invented underwear, right? We got to draw these lines somewhere, guys. And no, really, yeah, right. I'll try to keep the racist jokes classy here, guys. This is, you might get it too. I don't, yeah, I'm not gonna say we weren't racist. People are still racist. I hope I made this point clear enough before. But yeah, there's always gonna be douchebags and fat hillbillies that are sexist. And yeah, come on, man, get real. The whole point of the forum is that we're both allowed to drop N-bombs, or what, you get it, right? Well, if you got, this is the thing, usually, not always, but the reason, we were, this worked for so long, the reason we clung onto it is, like, you might be surprised at how it nullifies a lot of these problems that I see in these societies, basically, where it's like, you're not allowed to hate anyone. Yeah, so if I allow you to hate someone, I don't, no shit, dog. If you're allowed to go hate people somewhere, then you feel, when someone offers you the chance to hate someone, you're like, yeah, what, it's less enticing. It's like, yeah, that hero syndrome where it's like, oh my God, cool, I'm allowed to go, yeah, I have a reason to be an asshole now and people will like me for it. Seriously, I know exactly, yeah, get real, get fucking real with that. I think we all know what that's like. And I guess this is my best argument against the whole PC agenda and as social justice warriors, guys. If we're not allowed to call each other names and right, if I have to tiptoe around every, whatever, tiptoe around you too much, you get it. You are so susceptible to this hero syndrome of the crusade, the war, yeah, the social justice warrior, Taliban, fucking jihad of crazy bitches. Yeah, I get 100 million Karen jihadists coming around. Yeah, you get it. How far can we take this, ladies? That's, I'm speculating beyond that point. That, yeah, I'm not telling y'all what to do. That's just in my opinion. And I guess, The point is, we're both a little racist. Yeah, each of us have racist people hanging out in some of these guys driving around, driving over Volkswagens, driving Volkswagens over Panzers, fucking under over bridges, in and out of fucking wherever. Yeah, you get it. Yeah. We'll name these places later, dog. Straight up, we'll name these places when we have time to do anything else. I don't doubt some of the natives here are thinking, yeah, guys. It can, yeah, I don't, I'm not saying it could have been better, but yeah, things can always be worse. Imagine it was a bunch of fucking tanks. So yeah, if you've ever wondered why Africa's so fucked up, that's a few reasons. Yeah, we definitely played a part in this. Yeah, it's not like our, yeah, I we definitely got some blood on our hands. Fucking goddamn, yeah, we got some blood on our hands. Yeah, the point is, again, it's less so about quote unquote racism, because that, you know. A billion buzzwords in a beehive, right? If me like saying the wrong words, it falls in the same criminal record as owning the Dutch Indies, mate. Or, guys, like I know a lot of you get it, but it's like you must see how, from the other perspective, how hipster douchebag this is. Straight up, it's like you're literally allowed to own millions of slaves and be like, well, it's debatable how much of an issue that really is. It's like, brah. Right. And then as soon as we get involved in any conflict, right, or dude, you're like starting jihads from here to fucking Syria to Hong Kong, and like, right. And it's like, humming and hawing over. Well, yeah, that is, yeah, it's not a good thing, but it's, yeah, tolerable. You'll use, yeah. God damn it. And with us, it's like, I'm not saying these are good things, but you get it. Like, a couple countries get fucking, yeah, straight up, we've destroyed countries before. You've destroyed, yeah, half the fucking planet, Scotty, straight up. Yeah, and what about, yeah, Romans? Yeah, take, guys, welcome to the forum, brah. I think we're all Roman by now, bud. The Romanics, the Germanics, the Austro-German Roman, yeah, the Latin douchebag, fucking bankrupt Amundo, fucking Scarface Diablo, yeah, the greatest evil of mankind is your fucking angry, grumpy grandpa back straight up. Why do you think I'm bitching at you guys so much? Yeah, no kidding. In a way, yeah, who started this? We did a long time. Yeah, many cycles ago, Shepard. Thousands of years before you had underwear. That is not a joke. And yeah, that's another thing they can use against us. Yeah, straight up, this is one of their heaviest artillery in their war chest. Yeah, as far as foreign occupation goes, yeah, come on, guys. It's kind of like the yeah, you get it. Yeah, Rome certainly did that to Britain. That's where England comes from. The Queen of England, that royal bloodline of King Arturius, Arturius fucking Imperator Caesar douchebag infinitus. Yeah, straight up. A lot of douchebag infinitus coming into Britain there. Doucheland the Third. Yeah, you get it, guys. Yeah, come on. That's, yeah, now you Doucheland infinitus the Third, or King Henry douchebag infinitus the Tenth, is the one bitching at us about this. And your grumpy, angry grandpa is here to fucking literally throw you in an Auschwitz gulag and fucking exterminate all his kids, basically. That's, exaggerated Greek tragedy exaggeration, but things are gonna get fucked up, guys. So yeah, let's finish setting up the elaborate thing of dominoes before we kick them all over and epically watch them crash everywhere. Yeah, I know someone's waiting to say, wait a minute, okay, who invaded what here? Yeah, how did everyone get here, right? Yeah, I'll try to. Yeah, right. How did we get here, Scott? Oh my God, guys. Yeah, back in with the Dutch Indies, mate, in the 1600s. Yeah, or back in the Latin douchebag eras. You get it, guys. Like I said, cycles ago, Shepard. There's a lot to it, but basically, yeah. I already went over, like, oh, how did the actual war start? We each played a part in it starting, and what? Yeah, we definitely. Yeah, if we weren't there, it sure wouldn't have happened. I'm just saying. I hope you can still take some level of culpability for, quote unquote, declaring war. Basically, I'm not wagging my finger at you. I'm saying if you declare war on someone, they might go straight Luftwaffe Blitzkrieg on London with a Focke Wulf Volksjäger and a Messerschmitt. Yeah, straight up. I'm sure they get it too. It's like, yeah, you guys bombed London. You declared war on us, and then we bombed London. Yeah, well, you had a good reason to declare war on us. I'm not saying you shouldn't have. But when you do that, yeah, you open the door, and then fucking in walks Diablo Gestapo, whatever, straight up, that close to that happening, guys. So yeah, in case you just got here, yeah, we did invade a couple countries. Yeah, like I said, we have done things like this. And in the long ago, Shepard, like cycles ago, and more recently with the people involved here. So let's try to separate the context. Yeah, since we're all fucking Latin douchebag Romans at this point, unless you, yeah, at this point the natives are like, okay, yeah, guys, you guys don't have to worry about this, unless you you're already a 16th cracker in the where, yeah, you get it. It's po Yeah, it's already happening to you guys. You get it. You're in the process of becoming Deutschland the Fifth or something. So yes, we did quote unquote start this war with things like Poland and Czechoslovakia and that. But, yeah, Austrian Terminator mob disaster. What I'm just saying, that's it's sort of debatable because it's like again, it's like if you're gonna start a war on behalf of another country and say, wait a minute, yeah, did you at least talk to them first? There was some communication, but you get it. Beep, 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 and throwing pigeons around, pigeon carrier pigeons. I am not fucking joking. It's like putting a letter on your dog and sending it over to your friend's house. We did, yeah, I'm just, all I'm saying is there was this much, oh my God. I'm just saying, yeah, whatever, to recapping it as we go in here, because yeah, how did we all end up here? My God, yeah. Well, we've both done things like this. You get it. It's not as simple as, yeah, good guy and bad guy. I hope you fucking get that by now. Yeah, we're both douchebag Infinitus, the fucking seventh king, straight King Henry, Rick James, Vatican going on here. You get it, guys. During the demolition derby, fucking Otto Krieg disaster of like tank fuck. This is like the biggest tank battle ever. You get it. It's kind of like the Duel of the Dreadnoughts. Yeah, this is the world's biggest demolition derby ever. It all across the Sahara Desert of North Africa. Yeah, again, the natives here. Yeah, guys, I know you guys went through a lot of harsh shit. We'll get to the natives here, but guys, straight up demolition derby, Otto Krieg of fucking panzers and dragoon tanks ripping around. As here come the horses. They're like fucking. Oh my God. Yeah, it can. I'm not gonna. Right. I'm not gonna say. Oh, don't. You shouldn't feel bad because this was worse. But yeah, no. Anything can be fucking worse, man. But yeah, it's worth noting that a lot of the Sahara Desert. I don't think many people live in the middle of Death Valley or Eastern China. Yeah, why does everyone live on the west side of China? In case you missed it last time, it's a big conspiracy about why no one lives in the middle of a desert in China. Yeah. People here wonder why no one lives in the middle of a desert in China. But come on, rational skepticism. But before you Google anything, yeah, okay. It can't be all just completely empty sand dunes. Yeah, if there's a country, quote unquote country here, there has to be at least one settlement, right? Yeah. Right. Well, most of the settlements were the Dutch Indies, mate. This is, yeah, straight up, you get it. It's complicated. Well, except for Egypt. Yeah. You might get it too. Well, but yeah, here's a great, again, coming back to the racism thing. Yeah. This is, we did start getting racist. Take a guess, guys. Yeah, the minorities. Yeah, guys, here. God damn, who's the minority here, guys? God damn it, I hope you get it. Yeah, since there's no Twitter, we're not bickering about it on Twitter, but you get it. When people see each other here, when I go to Egypt, yeah, when I see my douchebag Baghdad cousin, fucking goddamn Hashashin buddies, yeah, Jihad Crusade, we're very similar. Not that similar, but compared to you guys, yeah, you guys stick out like a sore thumb here. Anyone you run into, you look like ghosts to some people. There's some videos of a kid crying because he thinks it's a ghost. It's like a really white guy. Yeah, I'm just saying, regardless of your political views, if that's a natural instinct in your children, that, oh my God, he's a ghost. Yeah, we don't, yeah, they don't think that when they look at us. We look, oh, it's a human. Yeah, racism indeed. I'm just saying. Yeah, they can be way more racist than you thought was possible. Pure out of pure ignorance. Yeah, exactly. It's complicated, guys. Like I said, there's a difference between that sort of thing and straight up Auschwitz gulag trains for here, there, anywhere. And I guess the point to cap off, yeah, cycles ago, Shepherd. Yeah, Romans have slaves. Yeah, you're all equally fuckable in Rome. This is the thing. Yes, we can be very racist because I don't. Yeah, it's like if I have to do something bad, I'm doing it. Yeah, God damn it, that's like at the bottom of the. I'm just saying, it's not like I'd never consider the fact that you might be a native or not. But if someone's gonna kill me or not, or you get it, I don't care who's driving the tank. I'm blowing up the tank. You get it. I guess all I'm saying is, yeah, it's like you can say like, oh yeah, Romans were worse for slavery. Yeah, we had all kinds of slaves. Yeah, pick your whatever, pick what kind of slave you will from what region. Yeah, do you want African slaves or do you want fucking Indian slaves? Not well, yeah, they were doing it to us sometimes too, right? Way back in the day. Yeah, like I said, cycles ago, Shepherd. That's not a joke. It's not a fucking joke. It's like that's why it's all legends and folklore to us. It is ancient mystical legends from thousands and thousands of years ago, and we still. It's why we don't want to throw our religions away. Guys, get you, I hope you get it. The point is, yeah, if we're in a situation where we're going to kill a bunch of people, yeah, we're either doing it or we're not. If someone happens to be a certain race, it's you get it, like with Jews, it's like, yeah, that we'll get to the thing with Hitler, don't worry. I know that, yeah, we'll get to Hitler going nuts. Because that, yeah, that sort of happens right after, as this is happening and after this happens. So we'll get, that'll be like the capper. And no, straight up, hope someone's laughing. Once we're finished each section, yeah, the finale, the grand crescendo will be Hitler going fucking nuts and how that fucking was it's like throwing a cannonball at the dominoes that are already falling. Oh yeah, epic fucking fail there. So yeah, that's a little hook for the next, yeah, cliffhanger for the end of the season. Yeah, next time. Yeah, hope, don't worry, I'm not gonna leave the guys hanging too far on that. Yeah, before we get to Hitler going nuts, that'll be, yeah, we can wait for that. Like I said, this is the thing, you get it. There's already problems happening anyway. Him going nuts was just, again, the cherry on the sundae. It made it, yeah, you get it. That was just another problem that was going on. We like I said, we're still culpable for fucking a lot of stupid shit. I just helping you realize, yeah, there some people were trying to do things like that. Like we need to get rid of these people. I guess the best example with the Jews is like, well, there's a bunch of Jewish people living there. Yeah, again, it's like the Taliban thing, or you know what I mean? Straight up Mohinder's fucking Binder inspection at the airport. You get it? Is there a bomb in your turban, sir? Or is there, yeah, straight up, it's literally almost exactly the same. We've been through this, guys. Straight up 9/11 or what? And yeah, fair enough. America handled it a bit better than we did. Yeah, we're making it wasn't great. Yeah, it wasn't a good thing, but it was the lesser. If we had to pick between doing that again, yeah, a lot of benders might. Oh my God, maybe not. Right, and I can't even say that. Well, we're not even there yet, guys. We're not even there yet. There's another 50 wars before we get back. Yeah, to the next cycle, Shepherd. Oh my God, no, my God. They know too. That's the whole thing with Persians and Saracens and all. Yeah, the Middle East indeed. Fucking Doucheland the Zeroeth. Yes, I hope they get like that one. Before Doucheland the First was Doucheland Zero. Indeed, Doucheland fucking Zero. So whatever. I think most of you probably get it. Just to clarify, I hope you get more realistic. Try not to think of like straight up Looney Tunes logic. Do you honestly think each of us was like on a bloodlust? Like if I see a black person, I have to kill him. You know what I mean? Like that kind of paranoia. Like if you're a black guy in an elevator with the wrong Nazis, the ones that kill the black people. Yeah, the things like that have happened. But most of that was in America. America handled this much worse. Yes, I'm gonna turn that around. Turn that round table around on you guys. Yeah, laugh it up, Scotty. Yeah, as far as the Nazi propaganda, so yeah, America bailed and fucking cracked its skull open on the pavement on that one, guys. Yeah, the real quote unquote original Nazis, I guess you could say, or these guys, the fucking Slavic Latin douchebag fucking Austro-German pizza guys. I'm not what here now. I'm getting racist again. I'm just saying, guys, you don't have to be. Anyone can be a citizen, brah, but you can't bring the dildo ring. Yeah, exactly. You guys still have a dildo ring. It's complicated. It's a lot like Israel and Jerusalem. You're already colonized there, and you probably get with, what about 9/11? One of your strongest assets is Israel. That's one of our, most potentially dangerous military targets. They're like at the top. They're at the top of our 9/11 list. Literally, they are near the top of our 9/11 list. They are the most potentially dangerous group in the Middle East to us right now. Straight up, yeah. I hope you get it, guys. I hope you fucking get it. It's just like the Mohinder inspection at the airport, and it's just turned. Yeah, you get it. You might get it though. Yeah, you guys do have the Mohinder inspection at the airport. That doesn't mean that you all are robotically programmed to target Mohinder. You might not like all the Mohinder Binder. Some of them are nice, some of them are assholes. You get it though. You don't have to kill them all, right? Do you have to kill every a Chinese person you see straight? Yeah, no. Not, yeah. Get re it's like how, oh, did we all wake up one morning and that suddenly each and every one of us had that same, like, if I see any black people here, I have to. No. You get it. Again, yeah, there's still people with prejudices in that, but you probably get the difference between like the Dutch, the fucking tea and spice colony thing. Yeah, to you guys, it's straight up business, like fucking extortion racket mafia ring. Yeah, Latin douchebags or what? The fucking extortion racket pirate mafia of tea and spices. Right, like I said, welcome to the forum, brah. Are we all not Roman or what? This is, if we can't get, if you still haven't decided whether you're British or not, yeah. And as far as, oh, that was a long time ago? Yeah, cycles ago, Shepard. Before you had underwear was a long time ago. Yeah, get real. Get fucking real. If I can't say that was a long time ago, then motherfucker. Yeah, again, you can see. You're humming and hawing over that. Yeah. How many millions of slaves before I can start humming and hawing over this, that, or the other? But if I had a million slaves, motherfucker, get real. You'd be fucking condemning all hell and shit on me. Anyway, as for how the war started, we spent time going over the politics and the meeting with the UN, and yeah, we've already gone through that if you're really curious. Point is, you've already declared war on us, and are already in a straight up jihad with ISIS out of Syria, Lebanon, fucking Gaza Strip crisis. Yeah, right around the corner, bud. Straight up Taliban, 9/11, right around the corner, and the Jews are at the top of our 9/11 list because they're the most da potentially dangerous group of people. That's the yeah. Just straight up, guys. That's how I'm approaching this right now. Speculating. If I got this job tomorrow, whatever. I just woke up, one morning. Instead of being racist, I'd be like, oh God, I have to set up the most complicated security system. The airport inspection. Is there a bomb in your turban, sir? Yeah, that's where I'm approaching that from. And then, of course, there's Muslims living all over the Middle East. Yes, there are Muslims in the Middle East, dude. Yeah, if you're gonna, yeah, come on. Certain things I shouldn't. You can Google Gulag the shit. Google how many Muslims are in the Middle East, and then you'll be on some fucking FBI watch list. Yeah, now you're going to the Gulag. Right. That you're right. Even if that happened, that doesn't mean all of you need to kill all the Chinese people. No, you get it, right? I hope you can. I'm just trying to help you, as you see this from both sides. Yeah, it's okay. Right. I hope you don't think we all came here to like execute any the non-pure. Yeah. Right. You guys are whiter than us. We're into them. I hope you get it. Are when they approach the dragoons and when they approach the panzers, you guys are the like elite security force of all their colonies of the Dutch Indies, mate. Here come yeah. Someone hit the security alarm and the guards came. And then we came to fight the guards. I hope you see how to a lot of them. We're not like it's not. Yeah, right. I'm not want to act like we were heroes to some people, maybe. But no, you get it. It's more like the Taliban breaks into your prison one day. Yeah, you're not gonna cheer to get real. Are you gonna be like, yeah, awesome? No, you're gonna hide or whatever. You're still yeah. Point is, they blew the door open and you can get out. The guards are distracted. Francisco Franco can't come to the phone right now. Yeah, you get it. The management is not up. There's an open chance to run away. Something broke your chains. You get it. We shattered the control, and all I'm saying is when. I hope you don't think it's impossible. We hired black people to help us. It's like, well, obviously, yeah, get real, guys. You've already been doing this for centuries and you're still humming and hawing. No, yeah, you get it. From our perspective, you've been slave man running in the Dutch Indies for centuries. We finally shattered some of your control, and it's like, right. Do you think we came here to exterminate anyone who isn't whiter than you, who's whiter than Super Mario's Pizza Galaxy? Yeah, guys, come on. So yeah, again, get real. We didn't come here to fucking feed everyone. Yeah, this isn't a UNICEF foreign aid. Well, maybe I don't know. Yeah, maybe it is. I'm just saying we came here with tanks to blow shit up. We are drag racing across the deserts of fucking Libya and Syria. Fucking yeah, straight Taliban ISIS warfare going on with our first. Yeah, you get it. This is not humanitarian aid. This is fucking the biggest demolition autokrieg derby ever. Yeah, you get it. They didn't. They weren't. Hang, a lot of them weren't. Yeah, they wanted to get away from this. Some people were. Yeah, you get it. Some people helped us. Some people helped you guys. Some people were more or less willing. And I hope you realize, even with you guys, you got to realize if you live, maybe you don't let. Yeah, we used to again, Latin douchebags. We used to do this too. We get into your politics. Which one of you hates the other one? Yeah, which one of these bitches hates that one? Your ex-husband, blah, whatever the fuck is going on in their politics. You offer to give them power, the power to defeat all their enemies. Which one of you wants to be the dictator, the puppet dictator, right? We can give you the power to crush all your competition, and then you can rule it under us. Not that's the extreme. That's what you guys have been doing for centuries while you're humming and hawing about it. And yeah, we find you're right. And now that yeah, you get it. I just got to Egypt. Yeah, you get it. And we're straight in ISIS already. And I guess to cap off this, yeah, before we'll get back, yeah, like I said, we'll get to Hitler going nuts last. But don't forget that, yeah, I won't tell you exactly, yeah, when to keep moving here. That was a long time ago because of the Auschwitz thing. You get it. You either have to look it up yourself or no, right? If you, I said, like I said, if you plant that flag too far, guys, yeah, come on. Don't plant that flag too far. All I'm saying is, most of you didn't know about the worst of our basically the one or two things that you have. Yeah, your two or three pieces of evidence that you constantly use against us. Hey, well, yeah, we're trying to be as culpable as I can. We gotta put the Dutch Indies on the scale, mate. Yeah, we gotta weigh these things on the scale of justice, not the lever of the Queen's tampon bin that only goes in one direction. We know that. I guess the point is, most of the Nazi propaganda came after the fact. You probably get it. You guys didn't see Auschwitz until the end of the war. So come on, yeah. Again, get real. The idea of us. Oh my God, yeah. You get it. None of you at the time, in context of this war, you didn't know we were evil yet, or it's complicated. You get it. We're still the bad guys, but the idea of, the Hitler hadn't gone nuts, or yeah, you get it. After Hitler had gone nuts, then yeah, the after effect. I hope so much of the Nazi propaganda, it came right after it was over, basically. Once you guys had seen the shit show festival, cottonmouth candy shit show festival, raven blood soaked piss and urine all over the walls of fucking wherever. Yeah. You saw the night after our big rave, and we're like, oh my God, Auschwitz gulag or what? The point is, here in this war, when they meet the Nazis, get real. We weren't that. Yeah, they would have no reason to think that until later. You know what I mean? We hadn't become like that to them. Yeah, not to mention propaganda. I don't think most of these people had radios or TVs yet. They still had cities, and you know what I mean. But most average people didn't have a cable TV. You get it? CNN, fucking Glue Dobbs or something. Glue Dobbs is the shaman now. I hope most of you get it though. I'm just trying to clear up the things that might. Yeah, you get it. Obstruct the first step of whatever. You get it. If you're thinking from your perspective, like, oh, here come the Nazis, yeah, the idea of us cleansing ethnicities or whatever, that propaganda, you guys didn't see that until after this had happened. So there's no way these people could have thought that same, you know what I mean? That propaganda, I hope you can see what I mean. Again, I'm not saying it didn't happen. I'm just saying, yeah, you didn't know, they didn't know about it yet. So, yeah, certain ethnic groups were getting rounded up. Most of them not because of their ethnicity. In a few cases, it was. Again, Binder inspection. Yeah, he's potentially Mohammed. Anyone with a name that sounds Israeli, you get it. Any name like Mohinder, Binder, fucking you, Harminder, yeah. If you work with Jack, Bob, Smith, and Harminder, yeah. Is there a bomb in your turban? We've already been through, guys. We've been through this. Even young people remember the 9/11 shit. Yeah, come on, guys. Well, yeah, that was a long time ago. You probably get though how yeah the whatever suspicion yeah the general public had some suspicion of Jews, not because of they weren't of a pure race, but because yeah he might have a bomb in his turban. You get it. They are. They swear you're not supposed to bring the dildo ring to Rome. I know, yeah, I know, it's getting close to edgy territory. Basically, we had the feeling they could still be loyal to straight up the Britannic Empire. We don't know. We again, beep beep beep. We, as far as we know, these are citizens of the Britannic Empire living in the heart of our capital. Who could you get it? That would be imagine a bunch of yeah straight up Gestapo Diablo living in fucking London, mate. Yeah, no, straight up, mate. Your neighbor is this guy. That's basically. Come on, yeah. It's that's a little stretch of the taffy a little bit, but you get it. People who could potentially be yeah. And you get, we've been through the Binder inspections at the airport. I'll admit that America handled that better, but they handled the Nazi propaganda worse. Some of us are better at different things. Yeah, we're all trying to make progress here. Oh, almost forgot. Hey, perfect extra throwing it onto the pile. Yeah, my 700th piece of evidence compared to your three. Again, I want to be culpable for the three or four things you have against me. But goddamn, if we can weigh the thousands of fucking bills for the tea and spices from the Dutch Indies, mate. Yeah, before Hitler went crazy, and then we can deal with Hitler going crazy, and then Stalin's gonna get here with all the fucking nukes. Yeah, and that, yeah, straight up. Yeah, and then shit's gonna get fucking crazy. Yeah, when you're the comparison of the Japanese internment camps, that's the thing. In a way, I feel like they're equally bad. Yeah, right. There's no right way to run Auschwitz Kampf. Yeah, it doesn't matter what you call it. It's a fucking Google gulag, whatever. No, they're all gonna be. We might as well mass produce them out of a Google fucking Amazon factory. You know what I mean? They're all. It's just Max Thug lockup with a different tattoo. It's all the same shit, dude. I hope you get the idea on each level, like just psychologically. You guys did the same thing. There's Japanese people living in America. Oh, yeah. If you're of this happened, guys, come on, get real. So to you, again, it doesn't mean you have to. Everyone woke up one morning, and if they any of them saw a Japanese person, they would immediately kill them. No. Some people might call the cops. You get it. Some crazy hillbillies might shoot them. You're right. You get it. There's different. Not every. Yeah. So with us, same thing. Some people are more paranoid than others. Some people are, their job is to run the Binder inspection at the airport or come up with any security measure. Yeah. Oh my God. All I'm saying is, if you're still thinking like, yeah, you know what I mean, like a straight up vampire, fucking demon, Dracul bloodline. If I see a person who's, yeah, you know what I mean. It's like you're worried that if you're they could just instantly kill you because, yeah, my God. Like I said, America is, that's, yeah, that's you guys flailing dildos on a five, whatever. That's you guys flailing dildos at Donald Trump's dildo factory over there in the New Republic. We'll get to it. We'll get to America. But yeah, I don't know. I don't want to put down every, like, whatever. We'll get to the neo-Nazis. Goddamn Cartman or what. There's actually a great joke in one of the Castle Wolfenstein games about this. I don't know if I mentioned it. It's the KKK. Basically, yeah, again, America. The KKK is not, yeah. It's completely different. Those are the ghosts of the Confederacy. Yeah, whatever. Yeah, no, I don't doubt it. These guys didn't. What? Yeah, they didn't know that. I know they're the ghosts of the Confederacy, bruh. There's some drunk ass hillbilly fucking redneck crazy motherfuckers. I'm not saying y'all. Yeah, y'all patriotic Republicans or what? We got a lot in common. Yeah, no shit, dog. Right. You get. Yeah, the Alamo used to be in Austria. Yeah, no shit, but you get it. Do you really want to deal with Hitler's bill for the tea and spices? Yeah, no, this shit's complicated. He's. Yeah. We, oh my God. All I'm saying is, again, you guys have already done, you guys have done this more. The thing that you are thinking of is like looking for people of a specific race, such as the Dutch Indies. Yes, we did that 5,000 years ago. You did it 50 years, 100 years ago. I hope you can see how frustrating this is. Most of you probably get like the core idea, but it's like, okay, what's the point? Like, how do we move forward with this? Yeah, that's a good fucking question. We're working on it. Again, just the concept of, okay, whose fault is this? We're all involved, right? Yeah, I don't even want to dump it all on Britain. But again, it's like things like America, or yeah, I don't know. Yes, America is shiesty today. Yeah, the Caesar douchebag infinitus, whatever. Right. If you just keep ignoring certain things, like, okay, now that you know what, yeah, why do you think this happened? Right. It's complicated, but I don't know. I guess the furthest I can speculate on that, if farthest I'll stretch it, is that's probably where most of the initial tension came from. The Mohinder inspection at the airport, you get it. Guys, come on. Do you remember the Moslem hour? Yeah, fucking right after 9/11, the guy wearing a turban in your office is, yeah, someone, yeah. We've seen this happen very recently. That's probably how a lot of the initial suspicion started. And then, of course, Hitler going nuts. Yeah, they were one of many groups of people that got caught into a lot of bullshit. Yeah, exactly. And basically, the fact that, right, they got the most attention is that's you guys, the white guy commercials running. It's because they were the whitest group of people involved, the German ones. They're, you know what I mean? Some of them are whiter than us. Literally, that's basically it, like you guys. So, some of these people are whiter than us. So there's, and yeah, basically, so I hope you can see how that's not the motivation here. We did not come here to be the whitest people in the world. We're fighting the whitest people in the world, basically. But that's not why we're fighting you. It's not because you're white. It's not because you're Jewish. It's because we're caught in a huge fucking dildo ring. Literally, we're surrounded by dildo rings. So yeah, I'll try to zoom in a bit here. Basically, I'm thinking, first of all, yeah, Romans and Egypt, yeah, we're. The culture, like I said, if one of us went to Egypt, we would blend in much better, easier than one of you. Yeah, come on, guys, get real. Yeah, maybe I don't speak their language. I'm just saying they will see you coming from a mile away. Yeah, the only white guy in town. Me and him have a very similar enough skin tone. Sure, he has a, yeah, you get it, guys. Cousin, as opposed, cousin, one's my cousin, one's an alien. Literally, you're an alien here. Yeah, well, God damn it. You're the minority, guys. I hope you get it. In a lot of ways, you got, yeah, all the racism got directed, not all of it, but yeah. I can't speculate on every aspect of it, and I don't doubt some people were, helped you guys just think about it. Short-term selfish gain, like, hey, I can make some money for my family. Fuck those guys. Yeah, again, you get it. It's like, some people might have had to sacrifice very little to gain a lot in return. It's like, okay, if you help us secure Algeria, yeah, who wants to be the Prince of Nigeria, straight up Prince of Algeria? Again, you get it. It's like, yeah, you can be the straight up Prince of Algeria before you realize it's not the same as being the Prince of Nigeria. Exactly. Yeah, now you're stuck. Now you're the next King of Algeria, whatever. You get it. I don't doubt some people were desperate enough. Yeah, come on, whatever. After this is happening, be like, yeah. Right, this has happened throughout history again. Mercenaries, yeah, We've been through this, guys, back in the day, cycles ago, Shepard. Greek mercenaries have helped Persians. Persian mercenaries have helped Greeks. If you don't pay the mercenaries, they're going to fucking steal your Brigati. Yeah, we've seen it all, bud. We've fucking seen this happen before. And I guess the point here is, even if some people are racist, even if a guy like Hitler goes nuts, for the people on the front line, yeah, your job is to not, like, fuck this up. Yeah, make sure we... Yeah, you get it. These people... get it, like, business-minded. I mentioned something like this before. The people at the top of a lot of, you know, chains or whatever, even not the very top, but the guy in charge of this panzer unit, yeah, his job is to win a battle. Yeah, if he's caught up on making sure you're not... yeah, you get it. He doesn't have time for that shit. That's at the bottom of his list. His concern is getting oil for tanks. If there's a black guy with oil and a white guy with oil, that, yeah, it does. He's gonna buy the. Yeah, you get it. They're thinking you. Same with you guys, slave man running in the Dutch Indies. I know you're not doing it because they're that color. You're doing it because you can, literally, because I fucking can. Same reason a dog licks himself. So. Yeah, I don't know. It's less about, yeah, we're not here to free the slaves. We're here to destroy the empire. You get it. We're fighting over oil and land and blah, blah, blah. This is frankly, everywhere we go, there's another dildo. Yeah, I took a walk in any direction and here's the Britannic Empire. Fucking whatever, guys. Yeah, here you are humming and hawing. Well, is it okay for me to invade? Yeah, you already conquered the whole fucking continent. And now here I am in Egypt. Oh my God, man. Yeah, I hope you get it, guys. The point is, yeah, how far can you stretch the whole race thing? Yeah, that was a problem with the whole Hitler thing, but here, yeah, on one side is the whole, you guys fighting, when you guys fighting it out there, and the slave train running in the Dutch Indies, you guys are fixated on your business, they are fixated on their military campaign against you, we are in a straight jihad to Jerusalem with the Afghan Taliban fucking ISIS out of Egypt, and yeah. At the moment, Kuwait and Israel are like the two main, you know, bases of power, you know, goddamn evil war economy funded from the US fucking CIA government and the Queen of fucking England. Yeah, from our perspective, right, it would be like fucking Gestapo Diablo living in next door. Yeah, whatever, I'm just saying, guys. Yeah, you'd be calling fucking SS Gestapo too. No, I'm just saying. So yeah, as far as I know, like, we didn't have the ability to really invade these places yet. I don't doubt there was, yeah, I can't only speculate too much. Maybe small groups got here and there, but no, it was mainly fighting in between here, right? The coastlines, this canal here, you can't really see it on maps like this, but yeah, we basically dug a canal, the only other way into the Mediterranean Sea. So that's basically all we can do is secure this choke point into the Mediterranean Sea. And this is the thing. It's like, well, did the King of Israel send an army? Yeah, no, brah. Some Israeli people, some fucking Assyrian people, some Iraqi people, some Saudis, yeah, Saudi Arabians, some Libyans, fuck, yeah, a bunch of Binder fucking, God, Tukmushan Binders came by. Yeah, to you, they all look the same. To them, you look like a ghost. And when I put a turban on, you get it. We are similar enough to them that I can casually stroll in there, hire some mercenaries, you know, buy gas, buy fuel, and yeah, we got straight Taliban, ISIS, Mohinder Binders on our team, and so do you. Some of them are Israeli. Yeah, some of them, basically, the terrorists that you hired were Jewish, and the terrorists that we hired were Muslims. Basically, fucking basically. We'll get to it, guys. We gotta get back to this, but yeah, that's basically how this started. And you might be thinking, whoa, wait, are they yeah, Nazis, terrorists, communists, billion fucking buzzwords in a beehive? Right. When we do it, they're terrorists. When you do it, yeah, whatever. Yeah, what? When you have a million slaves, whatever. You get it, guys. Come on. Yeah, from our perspective, yeah, it's not like I'm expecting for you to get whipped. Yeah, God damn it. I'm just saying, I hope you can see how, why we were, oh my God. I hope it's not too hard to understand why, you know. Yeah, you get it. And I guess the easiest way to wrap this all up before we move on to the next part, sorry to keep you rambling so much, the easiest way to summarize the whole, you know, oh, well, would they really work with... Dude, they didn't even know what Nazis... Yeah, that word was meaningless. Yeah, billion buzzwords and a beehive. To them, it's like, oh, well, what does that mean? What's a Nazi? It's like, oh, straight up, they're not dragoons. For most of these people, we were an army that wasn't the British Army. Yeah, anyone... Thank God... Yeah. I made a joke about this before. Hey, you want to work with me or them? Yeah, thank God it's not the fucking British. For half of these people, they were just glad to see anyone show up that wasn't British, basically. So yeah, to erase, yeah, in the end, we were all being racist to you guys. So yeah, straight up, you can judge us for that.